Hello and welcome back to Rel React, the Billboard number one hits throughout the ages. We're in 1962. We are up to the last week of March for a song which was number one for only 1 week, but it was by a woman who is a longtime favorite of this channel and of the people who watch these videos. Her name is Connie Francis. We've covered, her previous two number one songs. And this is her third number one from all accounts. It is called Don't Break the Heart That Loves You. And I don't really know much else about it. Yeah, that's about it. I think we should just get straight into it. Connie Francis, we've listened to a couple of Connie Francis songs, as I said, and I can't remember if I loved them both, but I certainly liked them both, and from recollection I enjoyed her voice as well. So let's have a listen to Don't Break the Heart That Loves You by Connie Francis.
Don't break the heart that loves you so.
Don't break the heart that loves you. Handle it with care. Don't break the heart. Darling, please be fair. Why do you flirt and constantly hurt me? Why do you treat our love so carelessly? You know
hurt me. Please don't make me cry. I don't know what I'd do if you'd ever say goodbye. Remember, I love you so much, and love's life's greatest joy. Please don't break my heart like a child breaks a little toy. Sweetheart,
there we go. Don't Break the Heart That Loves You by Connie Francis. I quite like that. She's got a beautiful voice. I loved her singing on this. The song itself, it was all right. I'm not a big fan of talky bits in the middle of songs, which I know was very much a thing back then. And also the background harmonies were a bit muddy at times. But what do I know? This got to number one. I have yet to get a number one single. But Connie Francis's voice, I think this was her last number one, which is a real shame. Because I think her voice was something that could have certainly proven more. It would have had longevity, surely. I mean, she's still going. She had a career throughout, you know, up into the 70s. So there was obviously a call for her voice, but why she didn't get another number one single, I don't know. I don't have a list here of her number one singles. Let's go discography. Excuse me while I scroll through Wikipedia in the background so you can't see. Yeah, so she had a couple more top tens in 1962, but then it kind of all just went on a decline due to the late 60s. So maybe her style of singing fell out of fashion. I know we have a couple of commenters, or a few actually, who growing up at this time and were listening to this music, and maybe you can explain, was her style of singing, did it fall out of favor, or did she perhaps move to a record label that didn't promote her properly, or what happened? I'd be quite interesting to hear. There's something about a tragedy later in the 70s, but I don't know anything about that. I don't think this is the place to go into it, really. But let's just talk about this song. A lovely, sweet song. I didn't like the talky bit in the middle, but I know that's kind of the fashion in some of these types of recordings. And the backing vocals were a little bit muddied. But other than that, her vocals, Connie Francis's vocals, lovely, lovely. I really enjoyed listening to it yet again. And I hope you did as well. So on that note, I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.